Whatever that is happening to our country is not good.
Kaofela cha di elanga ma ya divuzi.
South Africa cannot live alone.
South Africa is pilili ka pilili tri.
And this is the problem of corruption.
Ye ino ba botata ba u sinyeletsa.
If we can have leaders who fear God.
Ara ka le ba itapele ba bo ifa morena.
Our people will never kill each other.
Batho ba rena ka sibula yena ka mogong.
I don't know if you're hearing me.
Etse ba lentwa.
If now you can see what is happening in commissions.
Aka bona lo je di dialang di metlotlo ye ka moka.
It shows that we had the wrong people.
Ora ora batho ba seng bona ne ba leteng.
We had the wrong people. I mean, another one just created a big job and say, okay, I want to make a road from here to Pulukwane.
Oh, my God, you're going to tell me how to come to Pulukwane.
The money of road to Pulukwane, build a house.
Chile taya tela ya uchwa maya Pulukwane ya
ganto. And buy a car. Now, look what is happening now.
Ntwe di elanga na jono ki.
This is a shame to us.
Ntwe osa visa orena.
It's a really shame to us.
Ki usa visa.
When you find a brother who looks like you.
Buto osa na lewena.
And you put light on him.
Wa mo
put fire.
It's a shame.
Yes, you go there, you burn the shop.
These things
that we are burning, they are from South Africa.
We are
killing ourselves, we are killing our economy. I mean, we're supposed to be marching to say, let's get the right way. Bringing everyone here in the right way.
Not to kill people.
Not to fight people this way. Because how are you going to, I mean, what will happen when you go to another people's country? What if all these countries say, hey, no, we don't want to come to South Africa again.
If
you
want to South Africans,
you can't sell. You are lazy people. It's not true.
I said it.
You South Africa are very lazy. You love to sleep.
South Africa are tavuroko.
Waiting for Mandela money.
Rie mechichelte ya Mandela.
It's not true.
I said it.
Are you not lazy?
Aletswafi.
And now you are getting a job from them, isn't it?
Othola mereko towa ubona.
Then what is the solution now?
So karabo itaba ifi.
They were supposed to be in our government.
To say,
okay, let's I mean monitor our borders. Whoever come here, come in the right way. And from there, whoever is having business, this is the law.
Yeah, business
these people that are around the others, they do business now. They take money out in a wrong way.
Baba ngabadia business by chachelete o by
but not to kill them. It's not a solution.
Fighting them, burning,
this, all of us, we are coming from Central Africa. You black people.
You are from one place.
You are killing your cousin. You are killing your brother. You are coming from there. All of you there. The issue of, no, I'm a South African. Is someone who did that. Is another person who wanted to make you feeling like you are better than other people. We need to stop this thing. I mean, let's pray against this thing. It's really painful. Especially if you know that a person like me who travel, I've got many brothers and sisters outside there. Many people that have helped me are not even South African. There's no South Africa. In South Africa, they don't travel.
But what
makes South Africa to travel now is because of tax now.
I don't know.
It's tax now. They want to get bigger jobs outside.
I'm
sure our government, what they will do, I mean, is to stop everything and try to secure our borders. Secure our borders, and then from there, and try to assess everyone inside. And we hire people who don't have corruption. Many of our police are corrupted. If they're supposed to deport you, they say, Chela. Come back, go on the other side. Don't worry. So if leaders are corrupted, even our police. Corruption is not only in police now.
Corruption is a police thing.
Now it has come to our people. Look what it is. Corruption.
What
burning tires, burning shops. Burning in town like that, Pretoria. Like that, burning. Capital Power, people are running. Joburg, problems everywhere. This can really create enemies.
Amen.
Out of our country to come.
And amen.
These people, when you are trying to throw them away, try to beat them, now there are other people who penetrate and enter here. You just hear that they are bombing there. They are bombing. So what is important now in our country is to secure our borders. After they secure our borders, they come to agreement with the neighboring countries like SADC. The first thing, if they wanted to prosper people, was to say, people of SADC, let's try to make sure that we solve their problem. So that
people
must not run here. If you solve the problem of, let's say, Zimbabwe, when the problem is solved there, when we have got a problem, they will solve our problem here. But if we leave them and we allow people to run to us here, what will happen when we have got a problem? All of us will run to another country. So there will be an issue of running, no solution. So I'm praying that you people, we need to stand up today and we pray for our country so that all these things, it's a painful story. Painful. We vendors, especially we vendors speaking, we have got our relatives in Zimbabwe. Peri also, they are there in Zimbabwe. Others in Zambia. We are, you people here, Zulus, Zimbabwe, they are here. When you come this side, there they are in Develes, here they are Zulus. I'm sure you understand that. In Swaziland, they are Shatis. We are all one people. So if we try to say, let's beat this one. I mean, look here, there are Chinese, there are Indians, also there are other people here. They are doing business. No one say anything. No one is saying anything. You are just chasing your brother. Chasing. And now you are Peri and you are trying to speak Zulu. He's so shy, but you know very well. Pull like a spade so that people can arrest you. It's really painful. Let us all stand, we pray against this. It's a spirit. How many of you know that this is a spirit? Huh? It's a spirit, isn't it? It's a serious spirit, this one. There's nothing called this one is a Zimbabwean, this one is a South African, this is what? This is a worldwide. We are all, especially if you are Christians, we are all children of God. Huh? There's nothing called here, this is Mutswana, there's what? This is something that you have been colonized to do that. When your mind is being programmed so that you see this person as a Nigerian. This one is a Nigerian. This one is a what? You don't call each other by, this one is my brother, he's a Christian. This one is my sister in the Lord. So you talk about Nigerian church, South African, you understand what I'm trying to say? We need to change. We pray, God will give us grace. Are you ready to pray? How many are ready to pray? Let me ask two people, what do you want to pray about? Can I get to? Can you just stand there? Let's bring Mike there. You want to pray about what?
So that there must be unity in Africa.
Unity.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Let's get another one. Also. Let's bring a mic here, please.
Peace in our land.
Peace in our land. Peace. Thank you. Another one. Let's get the last one.
For God to forgive us.
For God to forgive we South Africans. This is sin against us. Because our leaders are sinning. Now our people are sinning. Okay, let me hear my sister.
For us to love one another and let love lead.
For us to love one another. For us to love one another. I mean, where thereby, because look here, this thing, if you kill your brother, one day you'll find yourself in that land. How are you going to feel? If you just kill your brother, one day you find yourself in that land and you are searching for a job there, how are you going to feel? You would rather stay here and die poor here. People are traveling all over the world. They are searching for their welfare. If a person, not all people from Botswana can come here, and not all people from South Africa can move out. I'm sure you understand that. Moving, you can't stop it. But issues of now the people have moved, our government must find a way of dealing with these people in the right way. And find a way of dealing with it in a right way, where also it will benefit these people. But many people are crying and fighting. They don't want to work. They don't want to do anything. They don't want to do anything. Not long I found that many people, many pastors in Africa, they are coming here. But it's not all pastors. It's not all pastors who are coming here. Even others are going to America. Others are going everywhere. I'm sure you understand that. So there's issues of moving, but issues of now when other people start to prosper in our land, we fight them. Somewhere we are doing wrong. If we pray and we do what is right, if they are prospering the wrong way, God will bless us. I'm telling you. I'm not saying they are not wrong people. They are wrong people. Others are dominating in a wrong way. Others, they are there. But the government must do something about that. Not us. So because of corruption, maybe that's why people are doing this. But we cannot support this, isn't it? Is it the right thing? It's a shameful thing. It's really shameful. Let's lift up our hands. Let's pray for our country, prayer. I can't hear you. Pray louder. Let's pray for our country. It's painful. Pray for our country. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. To be honest, we need foreigners here. We really need them. I can tell you that people like me, we have learned so much from the foreign people. In Christianity, we learn so much from them. Like now, can you see they are here, they are trying to do business. They are not teaching you, but they are teaching your children. Your children can learn from them. I don't know if you're hearing me. They are not teaching you. Yourself, you feel it's late. You feel like they are taking something from you. But your children, you can learn a lot from them. You can learn than to just fight them. Whatever comes, you fight. Whatever comes, you fight. And the moment when you fight, you don't learn. You don't learn. But now I say we pray for South Africa. We must pray for our government so that God must give them one wisdom to deal with the situation. Are you hearing me? Can we pray for our government? Prayer. Father, we pray for our government. We know this is the time where your wisdom is needed. We are praying that we need your wisdom. We pray that you lift the standard. Can you pray them all? Pray them all. Pray them all. Pray them all. In Jesus' name. Amen. You can sit down.